type of trade. Not a lot of professional traders know that much about it, you know, but the professionals do tend to be, you know, maybe have a little bit better than average performance, and certainly are a little bit knowledgeable about the markets. So it's something that I would encourage folks to investigate. It may not be your cup of tea for trading. It may not be. I wouldn't blame you. Okay, fine. You know, I'm not going to pass judgment on you. If you don't want to trade it like that, fine. You don't trade pairs trades. But I think it's worth, especially for you folks where you're at in your trading education. You know, you've been to the option classes, you've been to the high probability class, you know your stuff. You've been trading for a while. You guys get it. Or I should say men and women, not guys, but you all get it. And so now all we can do is just kind of show you some new things about pairs trading, for example. And you have to decide whether or not that's for you, you know. But it's out there. That's something that traders do. I do it, you know. You know, some of the other people, Thinkorswim, take a stab at it occasionally, you know, with varying degrees of success. But it's something that professional traders do. And something a lot of you folks might want to consider. All right, any other questions that pop up, Matthew?
What are the advantages of this over the other kind of trading?
What are the advantages of trading like this over other kinds of trading? Is there something specific here?
Well, you typically have much higher probabilities of success when the pairs trades line up. Let's put it this way. You buy a stock, generally speaking, it's a 50-50 proposition whether it goes up or down. You know, you're going to buy the spiders, well, okay, maybe it goes up, maybe it goes down. You sell an iron condor, you buy a calendar spread, you know, eventually the probabilities do work, but it's, you know, you may have a positive, you know, higher than 50% probability of making money. The bottom line is that the losers that pop up offset, you know, the few losers that you have offset the multiple winners that you have. So, you know, some of the standard sort of techniques are, well, you know, it's hard to find an edge. Pairs trading, because a lot of people still don't know about it, a lot of people don't do it yet. Pairs trading, when they set up, and you're going to do a lot of work to find a good pair, you're going to have to exercise a lot of discipline in executing it, but when they do set up, they have real high probability wins. In other words, if I could buy that ConocoPhillips ExxonMobil spread for $1, I would do it. Okay. You know why? Because it's probably almost certainly going to go higher, maybe to $2, but maybe to $1.50 at the very least, and maybe in the day. So am I going to make that 50 cents in a day? Very high probability, yes. That's a high probability situation. I will do that. And do I do it 100 shares? No. I do it maybe 10,000 shares in my account. You know, I'm pretty aggressive with it when I see this sort of thing. That's the advantage I see. But it takes a lot of work. It takes a lot of capital. It's not easy. But trading isn't easy. You know, that's where I see opportunities.
Got three more questions, Tom.
Sure.
First one is, can you review again about buying and selling of the first symbol? Does that make sense to you?
Yeah, what it is if you Matthew, if you can go back to the charts tab, whichever one we have up there, MNX versus Spider. Let's say does everybody see where the pair right now is 57.5, 57.5? If you think that pair is going to go up from 57.5 up to 70, you would buy MNX, which is the first symbol, and you would sell Spider. You would be buying the first symbol and selling the second symbol. Buying MNX, selling Spider. If you think the pair is going to go from 57.5 down to 40, I would sell MNX and I would buy Spider, which is selling the first symbol, buying the second symbol. Matthew, let's do a little exercise just to reinforce that point. Can you open up two chart panes? In other words, go to the the upper right-hand corner where you can choose multiple chart windows. Yeah, what you want to do is go, you want to be able to have two charts side by side. And if you just go to the regular software, just go to the regular charts page, and then in the up towards the upper right there, you see that blank, just go up two chart windows, next one. And in the first one, do the MNX minus spider. Okay, and we see that, and switch over to line. And then let's do, in that one, do spider minus MNX. We're just going to see the complete inverse of that chart. Okay, and then style type line. Perfect. Okay. It is the complete mirror image. It's a mirror image of each other. In other words, when one is high, the other is low, and another is low, the other is high. They're both the current price, okay? But in the right-hand chart, we're doing spider minus MNX. If I think that pair is going to go from minus 60 or minus 57 and notice how on the right-hand side, the numbers are in minus, minus 30, minus 40. If I think it's going to go from minus 55 up to minus 40, what do? I buy the first symbol, in this case, MNX. Or it should be, in this case, spider. Sorry, in this case, spider. I buy spider, sell MNX. That's the same belief, same trade as if I thought on the left-hand chart, if I thought it was going to go from 55 down to 40, sell MNX, buy spider. Okay? So the same trade. Same selling spider, buying spider, selling MNX, but just a different way of looking at it. So hopefully that sort of clears it up. But I cannot stress enough, you've got to be confident in that because you got to know what you want to buy and what you want to sell. That's really important because you don't want to screw that up and be right on your assessment of the pair and have your trade execution wrong. So if you're experimenting with this stuff, stop, take a deep breath. And this is a perfect thing to experiment with paper money. Perfect thing for paper money. Where, you know, you're worried about, you know, executions and getting the sides, you know, the long and the short right, and what you're paying, what you're selling, time frames, commissions, things like that. Try this out in paper money. See how it works for you. Maybe it's good for you, maybe it isn't. You know, and paper money is perfect for pairs trading when you're learning about it. Trust me, you know, 15 years ago when I was first doing it, I mean, that was before thinkorswim, obviously. But I would spend whole nights working on this stuff in a big spreadsheet. You know, thinking, okay, where do I make money? Where do I lose money? And I was doing, you know, volatility trades with this stuff. I was doing some pretty wacky stuff, doing pretty well at it. it took a lot of analysis. Pairs trading, paper money is a great environment for this.